President Clinton invited me to go and do a commitment in Clinton Global Initiative. So here's a picture where he gave his endorsement. So that paper says that we are going to fundraise together. So we managed $1.3 million together. Of course, when he said together, he didn't do anything. He just gave me his picture. But this picture is actually worth a lot. So other people power. In fact, he told me to start a royal flush gala dinner. Use the poker player, get the casino to, you know, sponsor, and then get all these Thai Thai to come for the dinner and teach them how to play poker, and then donate money down the toilet. Right? So very, very humorous gentleman, I think. So through the work, I then got named. I also don't know how it happened. I think they must have smelled something. The president of Singapore also came to help. You know, this is very interesting. He went to South Africa and he was visiting Nelson Mandela jail. And then he met two strangers who started talking to him about World Toilet Organization. So he said, oh, I know World Toilet Organization. They clean up the toilet in Singapore. Then those Africans said, no, he's not doing that. He's helping people who don't have toilets to have toilets. Then the president got embarrassed because he don't know his own citizens. Other people know. So when he came back, he summoned me to the palace. Tell me what you do so that next time when people ask me, I know how to tell. So that was a fantastic opportunity for me to. But I didn't do it like that. Very, very polite. So this was what happened. We got this star. This is Nishi Nash is a star, TV and movie star. And we got her to go to New York Central Station. Clorox paid for it. And we give out a lot of train tickets for New Yorkers to go to a town called Flushing. There's such a town in Queens, in New York, Queens, Chinatown, called Flushing. So we gave up 20,000 tickets together and lots of fun. And so we say this is the first time we transform poop culture to pop culture. And in the process, Clorox paid me $75,000 to do this stunt. It's very good. And then I was thinking it was very good until I heard that they pay Nishi Nash $200,000. Then I really get pissed off. So other than toilet, I also brokered Dialogue in the Dark. So this is some advertisement. Go to Nian Polytechnic. There is a museum there where you spend 1 hour in darkness, complete darkness. You cannot see. You are guided by a blind guide. The blind guide can see in the dark. And he guides you through a park, how to cross the street, how to order beer in the bar, how to pay money, don't pay too much because you cannot see your dollar, how a person lives in the dark through a typical day. And when you go into this museum, your life will change in 1 hour. Because once you come out, you are no more afraid of blind people, and you are also very appreciative that they have more adaptive power than you. Because when you were walking in the dark, you were so scared, you were not familiar. And he was your savior. So the esteem of the blind guide go up, and this cuts both ways. And why Nian Polytechnic will do this job? Because Nian Polytechnic has a social entrepreneurship diploma. And so they use this as a training course, training, real-life business or training. So you see the alignment? The alignment is educational institution, public awareness of blindness, the blind guide, self-esteem and income, and everybody win as long as you can align it. Yeah? So recently, I bought a piece of land, 10 acres in Malaysia, very, very cheap. You know that Malaysia land are very cheap. 50 cents a square foot. So I bought this land and I donate a 20-year free lease to anybody who want to do social work here. And I published it in NDTC, was 2.5 years ago. And Tay Kheng Soon, architect Tay Kheng Soon, volunteered. And now he designed this, and we have built already the big hall and 3 houses. And now we ask every school, every company also, you can build one hut and call it, for example, Allen and Glad Hill Hut. And all the Allen and Glad Hill lawyer can go there to experience out of comfort zone. No air con, no water heater, yeah. Got to draw water from the well, plant your own vegetable and eat. Yeah. So
you'd rather do free work.
You'd rather give me the money to build the house. So you know, then after that, I go away and Juhu here from NTU became the kampong manager. Juhu, there. Anybody who want to go to this visit this kampong, just contact him. So kampong Temasek will become a village built by Singaporean. And recently, just this morning, I met somebody here who is a foundation, and they wanted to help poor people in Malaysia, and I thought, what about we train the Orang Asli, the Aborigine, on ecotourism here? And this is called the School of Doing, not School of Reading, but Doing. So we are going to leverage on their interest to see if we can train the Orang Asli here. So these are examples. Come here, don't always go to conference to listen to talk like this. This kind of talk. Interesting, but other people talk not interesting. So you go and network and manage other. No, the some also interesting. Okay, so once you build houses like this, then let the young people take over. Then you can do other things. So just 2 months ago, I saw poverty is such a big issue, and how to solve poverty. 4 billion people are poor. If you give them money, also it doesn't help. So what about teaching them to do business? Since we know how to do it in Cambodia for toilets, maybe they can do the same with with water, with energy, with housing. So we create the first World Trade Center for the world. This is called the BOP Hub. BOP means bottom of pyramid. So the top of the pyramid are people like us, so rich. Right? Then the bottom is the 4 billion people who are poor. And BOP Hub is the trade center for getting everybody to trade each other. We have a trade mission to Bangladesh in March. So anybody interested to join the trade mission to learn how to do business for the poverty sector, please contact me. So this logo, I did myself. Okay, so we see the poor as our new customer. Why? The rich used to be high tech, high profit, but the top of the pyramid, too competitive. You make one handphone, people make 50 handphones. You make one tablet, people make 50 tablets. Recently, they launched 50 tablets. How to compete? So profit in the top of the pyramid is becoming very, very thin. High tech, high obsolescence. So things are getting obsolete. Whereas appropriate tech, that's what the poor need. So this is the future for the world trade also. Yeah. So what's sexy? How does people feel appeal? Okay, some girls are born sexy, some guys are sexy, this gentleman here is very sexy, but I'm not lah. So we have to say, then what else is sexy if you are not born sexy? Right? Your belief. If you believe in something strongly, your conviction, then you're sexy. Okay? Their interest and value. Your interest in their interest, right? So if you share the same interest, then you become sexy. Yeah? And your purity of thoughts. You're not doing this and then you do it because you... At first you want to do good, after all you want to be famous. And then you want to do it for your own ego. And then you start to get angry when other people is doing the same thing. Then something is wrong with you already. You have to do check and balance. So, purity of thoughts very important. Their ease of participation, the help you must be very easy to help. Not complicated, not bureaucratic. Yeah? And the synergies that 1 + 1 is not 2, but 1 + 1 is like 27 or something. Then they like it, okay? And that their mission and you are aligned, okay? So,